episode of Let's Play Indiana Jones and the Fate of Atlantis. Last time we were doing like an exorcism kind of thing on Sophia. She went crazy. We rescued her out of the dungeon. She went crazy, thought this was our home, and now we are exploring even deeper into Atlantis. We were like in the middle circle last time. Now this is like, I guess, the inner circle. We're gonna need to find some way, or there's a thing over here. Wait. There's like markings here. What are these markings?
Atlantean graffiti.
I suppose. I don't know if these markings are necessarily helpful.
More Atlantean graffiti.
There's like a tank here or something.
It's a huge version of the Microtar statue.
I think the Microtar statue is only in the Let's Play, but we haven't played that yet in this Let's Play, so we'll probably see it again later. It looks like it's missing some levers, so we're gonna use some our little rods and stuff.
Going up?
I'll wait down here.
Suit yourself.
You probably want to get on this thing with us until we start it.
It doesn't work.
We have the hinge pin and the king's scepter. Slots. We should probably also start it up with the auric alchemies. Although we don't have a third lever, we should just push things around and see what happens. No. There's probably some Atlantean graffiti around that, like, shows you.
It won't go down any further.
I'm at the middle lever, dude. Wanna, like, mess around with these. Every combination, we have to use the left lever, but the right.
That doesn't seem to work.
Pick it up. This might take a while because, still trying to figure out how to start this thing.
It's working.
There we go.
Get on board, Sophia.
It's a strange way of moving where it's like using its feet. Alright. Now, we're going to be going in circles for a while unless we mess with it.
That was close.
Too close.
Well, I'm glad we jumped off of that. Alright. Now, there was a certain point at this in this game where I found myself very annoyed when I kept trying to play invisible.
Stick close, Ted. This could be dangerous.
I'll take my chances.
So, if you somehow figure out how to become invisible and you get to this part gets really annoying. So all you have to do is walk through these
climb back up. The passage is too steep.
Nope. Okay, so you... Oh, there's a... Okay, there's a lot of things going on. But yeah. If you're going the right way, some vehicle will kind of, like, lead you, so you have to remember which doors you come in and out of. And it's kind of hard, especially for... being invisible.
Whoops!
So, the only hint you get is the camera panning with you. Actually, can I walk up the stairs before I go to that door that I just went in? Because I wanted to show something. Okay, over here. I don't want to remember this combination, so it's the full noob sign on the west, and this.
I can't reach it. I can't reach it. I can't reach it. I can't reach it.
He got stuck at the door. Like, that's weird.
Hold your horses.
Here's your shining city.
Not what I expected, that's for sure.
And the place is still humming, maintaining the air pressure for untold centuries.
Alright, let's go check out what this area is. It's like...
It's a receptacle for the stone discs.
So I think there's the stone discs here too. But there's not very many details here. There's a frog statue.
Looks like it's hungry for orichalcum.
Can we use orichalcum in it?
That didn't do anything.
We used the mead, so hopefully that didn't start anything for us. Now, I would recommend swimming here, which I'm going to do. Yes, this is the final part. Alright, so let's use the stone discs on here. Okay, yeah, so the reason why I asked you to remember the combination was because in this part, there is, this would be the Colossus, assuming the 10 beads could make yourself a god. Said it, you can also make freaks of nature, which are probably those weird stones that look like mermaids, or not stones, skeletons. Celestial spheres were well aligned, so that combination back there is the key for this. Which was the main sun here, moon here, volcano this way.
Uh-oh.
What did you do now, Ruby?
I think I turned it on.
You see, Colonel? I told you chords would be of some use to us.
Kerner, I knew I smelled a rat.
Oh, no.
All I smell, Herr Charles, is your pig. Don't move.
Mein Gott, how beautiful! Congratulations, Dr. George. You've just handed the Serpike its ultimate victory.
It'll take more than a few orichalcum bombs to conquer the world, Orin.
Bombs? The gods don't need bombs.
Take a look around. What do you think this astonishing machinery was used for?
Barbecues?
Wrong! As Plato itself well knew, this was a factory for manufacturing higher beings!
While you've been wandering around, we've been stockpiling orichalcum.
And now we have all we need! Are you ready for the greatest moment in history, Doctor?
I really don't think that is necessary. Also, as I said earlier, I took all those parts. There's no way that they could have made more orichalcum because I broke that machine on purpose.
Did you notice all those hideously deformed bones?
Experiments gone awry. Unworthy slaves sacrificed in the name of knowledge. Progress has its price, you know.
Maybe they were all too human, like you.
Subhuman, you mean? They were destroyed by their physical imperfections as they bathed in the awesome power of this device.
Fortunately, we suffer from no such imperfections.
That's quite a Nazi saying.
You really believe in this godhood business?
Why not? As a god, I shall know everything, be everywhere, rule everyone!
We both shall rule.
brother. You're not prepared for this.
We shall see.
Valhalla.
Godhood sounds good. I like a crack at that.
I like a man with courage.
No!
What?
If anyone's going to become a god, it must be me.
You? Don't make me laugh.
I am in charge of this operation, you spineless sausage. Activate the machine.
A test is a test. Total suggested 10 beliefs. Let's try that.
Wait.
What now, Charles?
We should probably let him know that there's a tenfold error.
What about Plato's tenfold error?
What about it?
Most of Plato's numbers were way off target. Just a thought.
Maybe right. We should divide by 10. Try one bead.
One bead it is.
That was two. Put one in there, remember? Or maybe it only counts as one.
Himmel! It's talking! A small bee for a small man, eh, George? Now it's your turn.
No thanks. Godhood's for egomaniacs like you.
Move! Unless you want my men to move you. That's better.
Whoa. Okay, so now we're on the platform. Save here again, just in case. Probably don't want to save over that in case this is the wrong place. Alright.
You need a calcum, you need a miracle.
Nonsense! I'll stop this playful number. Can be useful to print.
Wait, no.
Hang on a second. Please, Professor, don't make me do this.
Look at the bright side. You'll be leaving your cares behind.
Please, Professor, I've got classes to teach.
Stop whining, man. Let's not take chances. How does 20 bees sound?
No bees, you crazy old man.
Come now, Doctor. There's your scientific curiosity.
You know, you'd make a much better god than me.
That goes without saying, but there's no reason to turn up your nose at the chance to become one of the lesser immortals.
Listen, what if Plato's error went the other way?
How do you mean?
You can't buy godhood for a couple of beads.
All right, George, you decide. How many beads should be used?
No beads. Forget your stupid obsession.
Really, Dr. Jones, get a grip on yourself.
For your sake, I hope this doesn't work.
Why not?
Once I'm a god, I'm sending you straight to hell.
I'm offering you immortality. Is that the thanks I get?
You ever hear the term angry god? Wait till you see me.
Hang on. Perhaps I haven't thought this through. You want to go first. You're scheming against me in spite of my generosity. Well, you won't get the upper hand that way. Stand aside, Jones. 98.
We got him on the platform.
99.
Pretty well.
100 beads. Prepare to feel my wrath.
You know, a lot of my discoveries seem like tall tales, even to me.
Okay,
at least there's some evidence this time.
Evidence. And
then again, maybe not. What was that for?
To ease the pain.
Thank you.